That's so aggravating. All right,
Yeah,
so
that's cool.
what we're going to do, we're going to go through the scriptures real quick, and we're going to show you that we can have our heads covered as long as we're not praying or we're not prophesying. All the prophecies have already been wrote. There are no prophets today. 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 And we are not praying. So we can allow to have our head covered. And we're going to go ahead and bring that out in the scriptures and read it to you nice and slow so you can understand it.
1 Corinthians 11:4. Gotcha. 1 Corinthians 11:4 says, every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head. So here's the thing, Zion. We're not doing both. We're not doing either one. We're not praying. We're not prophesying. Praying. We're not prophesying. Praying. We're not prophesying. So let me tell you something. We're not prophets. We're not prophets. All the prophets have passed and gone. What we're doing is we're reiterating what the prophets have already spoken in his word.
That's right.
So,
and for you guys that still doubt, go ahead and pull up 2 Ezra chapter 1, and we're going to read verse 36. Okay? So we know, matter of fact, I'm going to start at verse 35 so Israel knows that it's talking about the nations of Israel that's today on the earth. Mm-hmm. It says, your houses will I give to a people that shall come. This is Ezra. He's talking about to the old Israelites, the wicked ones. He said, to your houses I will give to a people that shall come. That's us, right? Which have not having heard of me, yet shall believe me, to whom I have showed no signs, yet they shall do that I have commanded them. They have seen no prophets. Let me read that again. They have seen no prophets. So you see people out there on the corner calling themselves a prophet? They're a lie, because the Bible says we ain't seen no prophets. They have seen no prophets, yet they shall call their sins to remembrance and acknowledge them. Okay? Now that's the last time we're going to address that, far as, we got something in our head. Okay? I need you, before you want to scoff and say whatever, I need you guys, please study the scriptures and go back and study the scriptures again before you make sideways comments. Okay? So
I want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Bashim, Makakadosh, Brakatham, to all the brothers out there preaching in sincerity and truth. Shalom to the 12 tribes of Israel scattered abroad. So you can see, in reference to what this man is preaching, obviously he does not know the Bible, right? So every time, that's why the scriptures talk about to try a friend, man, right? You can't just jump in and just be hasty and just credit him for his works, man. You gotta try the friend, man. Try the spirit, man. The scriptures teach us, right, to always try a friend. Always follow the Bible, man. Don't follow any man on this earth, man, right? We all know the scriptures, man. Right, cursed be the man that trusteth in man, making the flesh his arm. Right, roughly paraphrasing. So, what's our whole point? What's the whole point of us doing this? Right, we are commanded, right, to follow Hamashiach Yahawashai, man. Right, and what did Yahawashai, when he was on this earth, what did he do, man? He destroyed the works of the devil, man. And that's why we're doing all these rebuke videos. In reference to these so-called prophets that claim to be prophets, man. And you heard that monkey, he said that there's no prophets in this world, right? So if there's no prophets in this world, how is prophecy meant to come to pass, right? So we're going to go to the first scripture and destroy this doctrine of devil of no prophets here today, right? I'm gonna warm up and kick it off with 1 John 3:8, and it reads, 1 John 3:8, he that committeth sin is of the devil, for the devil sinneth from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Right? And all his disciples, everyone that Yahweh Shai taught, right? We all know to rebuke these false doctrines, man. These doctrines of devils. You understand? So this is how you know this man does not have the Rukah Kadosh. Because Father said that the Rukah Kadosh, if his seed remaineth in him, right? In him, bro. He cannot sin, bro. What the fuck? You know what I mean? This is crazy shit. This is, bro, I told you, man, that the tares shall grow with the wheat, man. And that's a prophecy, right, that's happening right now. Right? You got the wicked false prophets, and then you got the righteous prophets all growing at the same time until the harvest comes, right? When's the harvest, bro? We coming to that. These niggas calling, saying that there's no prophets. Well, if there's no prophets, then how is scripture supposed to come to pass? You stupid clown. You've been preaching for how many years? 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1. So our whole point, right, is to destroy the works of the devil. Alright? So let's link it up. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressively that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Remember, sin is of a devil. And that's how you know that that person is not a holy prophet. Right? If he's committing sin, Father said, if the Holy Ghost dwell inside of you and his seed remaineth in him, he cannot sin, bro. Right? That's truth. Okay? So it tells you here what? We'll read it again. And we in the latter times, man. We in the last days, bro. As you can see, all the prophecies are happening simultaneously all around the earth, buddy. Right? Shit. 1 Timothy 4:1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter time some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, man. And we're supposed to rebuke all these false doctrines, man, that's in this world, man. Right? We have to come to sound doctrine, right? The unity of the faith, man. There's only one doctrine that's 100% truth, right? And that's the word, Yahweh Shai, man, right? Damn, man. So we can see that we're living in these last days, man. See all the doctrines of devils? You got the saints rebuking all these false doctrines, right? And I showed you many precepts in that video of your transgression, bro. You gotta link up the right precepts, right? You can't just go around talking smack, right? You're taking shit out of context, man. Read 2nd Edras, right, properly, man. 36, right? Read the whole read the whole chapter in context, man. Stop playing, bro. The saints wanna get the fuck home, bro. You niggas wanna fucking play around in these last days, right? So there's no prophets today, he said. Right? I'm gonna rebuke more of his bullshit when I'm on the highways and hedges, bro. Right? So he said there's no prophets today. Let's prove him wrong. Right? How else would we have woken up, you dumb clown? How else would we walk? When he said he poured his spirit upon all his people, what does that mean, you clown? Right? I go to these strange babies. Right? So he said there's no prophets today, right? So let's prove him wrong. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 20 to 21, right? 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 20 to 21, go to it. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. So it says here that no prophecy of the scripture. So if you're teaching the scriptures, you're teaching prophecy, dumbass. You see how fucking dumb these niggas are? For my people are sottish, for they have not known me. They are wise to do evil, and to do good they have no knowledge. Fucking dumb. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 20 to 21. Knowing this first, that prophecy of the scripture is of Slacky, let me read it again. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 20 to 21. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture, right? So the scriptures that you're teaching is prophecy, dumb clown. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scriptures of any private interpretation. For the prophecy came not hid in old time by the will of man, but of holy men of God, Yahweh, spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost, the Ruach HaKodesh. You stupid clown. You know the Ruach HaKodesh is called the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of understanding. That's why we have a quick understanding of the Bible, man. Right? That's why we have quick understanding of the Bible. The spirit, it says that you're being renewed day by day. So when the Holy Spirit is inside you, it should be making you better. That's why he'll direct our steps, right? The Bible says that he will direct our steps when the Holy Ghost dwells inside of us, right? So we've been renewed day by day. Father made it more easier by giving us the Holy Ghost. Plain, bro, plain. Plain to the holy and a stumbling block unto the wicked. This is how we know you we live in a wicked lifestyle behind closed doors, you dumb nigga. I wouldn't even call you a nigga. You're a strange child, bro. Right? Let's see if you can take this rebuke and this chastisement. Right? We'll see. I'll check up on you 6 months later, bro, to see if Yahweh Shem Yashai lives inside of you, bro. Right? So let's go to Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. And it reads, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not to thine own understanding. Right? So you're not supposed to make up bullshit. You gotta speak according to the law, bro. According to this word, man. You can't make up bullshit. You're making up bullshit, we know straight away that you're a sinner and you're fucking wicked, man. Right? Quit playing, bro. The saints ain't fucking playing. We put our foot down, bro. We want to get out of here, bro. You stupid asses want to mingle and shit. All these false doctrines, bro. You got to watch out for these strange babies, man. Right? Watch out for these strange babies, man. So it tells you here, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Right? He said, give all thine heart, all thy soul. He didn't say, live a doubled life. Right? And preach the Bible and go sin behind closed doors, and then you get a saint to come rebuke your false doctrine, you dumbass. You're a false prophet, man. Right? So it tells you here, lean not to thy own understanding. This is a commandment. You're not supposed to make up your own doctrine. Right? The saints preach one doctrine. The Heavenly Father's doctrine was passed on to Christ. That's why it's called the doctrine of Christ. And then you passed it on to our people. So you gotta follow that order, man. You gotta follow his son. He told you to follow him. That's a commandment. That's how we know none of you niggas, right, in America and the United Kingdom, that's how we know you ain't following his son, man. You know what I mean? With your false ICBM missile doctrine, all this shit. Too many crazy shit going in these last days, man. You can see the violence all around the earth, man. In every country. I told you on the highways and hedges to check the crime rate in every country, man. This is not a game, man. Right? We in our serious times in these last days, man. And I want to get the fuck off out of here, man. Right? I want to get out of here. You want to get out of here, you want to stay in this world, man. If you want to stay in this world, you're going to die with the world, man. Right? So obviously, the Spirit is telling me that you are fucking sinning behind closed doors, man. How long you been preaching this Bible, man? Right? The Lord got me in this truth in 2019, yo. And I'm getting perfect. I'm not perfect yet. Right? Because it tells you in the Bible, in reference to when we're perfect, right? I know that art ready to die, right? So you should be able to finish off that sentence, right? The precept that I'm talking about. Unbelievable, the shit that's going on in these last days, yo. So Ecclesiastes, let's go to the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 22, verse 13, right? Ecclesiasticus chapter 22, verse 13, bro, right? Talk not much with the fool, and go not to him that have no understanding. So we have, if he has no understanding, right, he doesn't have the Holy Ghost. Because the scriptures say that if he has the Holy Ghost, you have the spirit of understanding. That's why we have a quick understanding of the Bible, the Spirit quickeneth us. Right? You gotta remember in the old covenant, we couldn't receive it. He made it more easier for the future, right? Of our future, so that we can walk righteously, man. That was the whole point of the Heavenly Father's plan, right? To save his righteous children, not the wicked ass Israelites. That's why it says, not all Israel's Israel, man. Because only the righteous of Israel are going to make it into the kingdom, man. Right? So talk not much with the fool, and go not to him that have no understanding. Beware of him. Watch him, bro. Watch his wicked ass. Lest thou have trouble, right? Dramas. Yeah? They'll get all physical and try and fucking be violent because they can't handle the truth. You know these type of wicked niggas, bro, you know they ain't got it, right? Beware of him, lest thou have trouble, and thou shalt never be defiled with his fooleries. Defiled. Father said in the Bible, in the New Testament, through Apostle Paul, to not defile the temple of God. For he that defileth the temple of God shall be destroyed, bro. Shit. You dumbass. I gotta put my fucking foot down because you niggas ain't fucking listening, man. You wanna get your asses home back to our homeland? And that's another case, man. How are we supposed to go home back to our homeland if there's no prophets here on earth in the last days, you dumb clown? Shit. Right? So it tells you in Ecclesiastes 22:13, talk not much with the fool, and go not to him that have no understanding. Beware of him, lest thou have trouble, and thou shalt never be defiled with his fooleries. Depart from him. Depart from him. Nah, just start rolling with the seed of Israel, even though they're preaching false doctrines. Depart from him. Nah, they're kind of cool, man. You know what I mean? They're kind of cool, they're all right. But they're transgressing the law. Depart from him. Thou shalt find rest and never be disquieted with madness. All right? You keep listening to this madness, bro. You're going to be mad like them. They're going to be fucked up in the head. Right? You're going to be still in transgression listening to these idiots. Because you know that being deceived by the devil, right? Because sin is of the devil. And this nigga just sinned, saying that there's no prophets, right? In the last days. And sin is of the devil. So this nigga, this motherfucker, do not have the Holy Spirit living inside of him, bro. Right? See? So let's go to the book of Acts. All right? Let's see what Apostle Peter says, right? In reference to the gospel and the word, right? Acts chapter 5, verse 29, we'll go to. And it reads, then Peter and other apostles answered them, and said, we ought to obey God rather than men. Nah, I'm just going to listen to these false doctrines and fall for their bullshit. We ought to obey God rather than men. Nah, I'm just going to fucking just roll with them, man. They seem all right. You know what I mean? We ought to obey God rather than men. So he tells in the Bible, you got to obey God, Yahweh, man. These scriptures, man. These scriptures are commandments, man, that we got to follow. Right? He said you got to obey God, Yahweh. Right? Obey God rather than men. Right? So let's see what happens when our people don't want to listen, right? Because we all know why we under the curses, right? Because the children, you know the scriptures, man. Deuteronomy 28, 15 to 68, right? So we go to Jeremiah 17 and we go to verse 5. Thus saith the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Yahshua, cursed be the man that trusteth in man, and maketh flesh his arm, and whose heart departeth from the Lord. So it says here, if you trust these fucking niggas, right? These strange babies that's preaching our Bible, right? Because this Bible's for only black folks, man, right? And we all know the children of Israel are black, bro. We can prove it in the scriptures, right? So it tells you here that you're accursed. So any of you fucking stupid ass niggas that want to follow these men, these false prophets, right? It tells you that you're cursed, right? Because you trust in these wicked ass niggas that want to transgress the law. I can't believe no one has rebuked you for this shit, man. It's crazy. That's how you know these niggas ain't brothers with each other, because you're not correcting people, man. Like, who's watching your back? And what name are you calling upon, right? Crazy. Jeremiah 17:5. Thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man, and maketh flesh his arm, and whose heart departeth from the Lord, right? So it tells you you're cursed, man. You gotta remember that being deceived is a sin, right? It tells you in the Bible, you've been deceived by the devil, because sin is the devil. And this strange child just sinned. So do you think that he has the Holy Ghost living inside of him, bro? The Spirit should have told you straight away that these niggas are not the prophets of the Lord. If they're claiming that there's no prophecy on earth, then how is prophecy supposed to come to pass, you dumb shit? You don't have the Holy Spirit. You can't see scriptures three-dimensionally, bro. If you could, I would know that you have the Holy Spirit, right? So quit playing, bro. You can't fool the saints. Yeah? So let's go to Psalms. I will finish off with this scripture. Alright? We'll finish off with this scripture. I will go to Dumbass. This is such a shame, man. Right? And he said that there's no prophets in the last days. And then he cuts himself by using Tobit chapter 4, verse 12. You're a fucking clown, bro. You're a fucking clown. Clown, man. Shit. You fucking wonder why the Lord put us into how many captivities, man? Shit, man. So let's go to, we'll finish off with this last scripture, man, because I'm going to go on the highways and hedges and rebuke this demon, bro. Right? Because it's got to be done, man. Right? It's our job, man, to destroy the works of the devil, man. That's the whole point. Rebuking all these false prophets for their false doctrines, man. Right? You gotta look for the saints that are rebuking them for their lies. That's why I told you in the highways and hedges, right? When a prophet says something, go to that scripture, go to the scripture that he's breaking it down, and see if he's breaking it down properly, right? See if he's breaking it down properly. I told you, man. You see what you fucking stupid. Ah, people are fucking dumb, man. They fall for these stupid ass false prophets. Right? Crazy, man. Psalm 64. We got a book of Psalms, chapter 64, verse 2. And we'll read on to verse 10. Hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked, for the insurrection of the workers of iniquity. Because you're going to get paid back for your sins, you stupid ass. Everything that you do, you gotta remember, it's not what goes inside of a man's mouth that defiles a man. It's what comes out of a man's mouth that defiles a man. You gotta rule your spirit, man. You can't rule your spirit. You're not following the instructions of the Bible. Hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked, from the insurrection of the workers of iniquity, who wet their tongue like a sword and bend their bows to shoot their arrows, even bitter words. They that may shoot in secret at a perfect, suddenly do they shoot at him, and fear not, because these niggas don't fear, man. If you feared the Lord, right, you would follow the instructions of the Bible, and the saints know you ain't following when you transgress the law of the Most High, alright? You can't hide, nigga. None of you niggas can hide in your stupid strange children that are preaching our Bible. We know, man. Stop playing, alright? Psalm 64:5. They encourage themselves in an evil matter. Right? What's that evil matter? Right? There's no prophets today. There's no prophets today. Clown. And then he tries to, he falls on his own. Oh, well, I'm going to bring it out, Salakia. Give me a sec. So we'll go back. Psalm 64:5. They encourage themselves in an evil matter. There's no prophets today. They commune of laying snares privily. They say, who shall see them? Yeah, he's gonna see you. You know the devil's laying snares, yet I have not erred from my precepts. Shit, you see how the ghost is flowing? Damn. They encourage themselves in an even matter. They commune of laying snares privily. They say, who shall see them? Right? This is what these wicked ass niggas with these false doctrines. Right? These doctrines of devils. Right? G-Man, Sakari, all these niggas, man. Even you got even got people that's not part of camps you gotta watch out for. I told you this too in the highways and hedges. Watch out for the people that are not part of camps, and then you gotta watch out for people that are come out of camps, because not all of them, right, are saints. Right? You gotta look for the saints, man. Fish for the saints. That's why Christ taught us to be fishers of men. Right? To catch the fishes, man. The word is the bait. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. Right? So we have to continue preaching until we catch all the fishes. The lost sheep of Israel, man. Right? Damn, man. So these false prophets with these doctrines of devils in America, man, they've been pushing their shit for how long, man? Right? 30 years. Plus, you got the times of Noah playing out with all these false prophets allowing heathens into the covenant, marrying them. They're fulfilling the times of Noah. The days of Son of Man be like the days of Noah. The days of the Son of Man be like the days of Noah, man. Right? So it says here that Psalms 64:5 and read on to 10. They encourage themselves in an evil matter. They commune of laying snares. They say, who shall see them? Right? The devil laying snares. Right? Yet I have not erred from thy precepts. Right? They say, who shall see them? Verse 6. They search out iniquities. They accomplish a diligent search, both inward thought of every one of them, and their heart is deep. But Yahweh shall shoot at them with an arrow. Suddenly shall they be wounded. So they shall make their own tongue to fall upon themselves. All that shall see them shall flee away. And that's what the Heavenly Father did to your wicked ass. Right? So he did to your wicked ass, man. So that's what he did to your wicked ass, man. Right? That's what he did. He tells you here, so they shall make their tongue to fall upon themselves. All that shall see them shall flee away. Right? Because of your doctrines of devils, man. That doctrine that you got there, though, there's no prophets in the last days. That is a doctrine of devil, man. Right? And that's why I'm proving it. I'm going to go on the highways and hedges to rip up and cut your doctrine, man. Because I'm getting sick of you false prophets. Right? Talking shit, man. So it tells you that Yahweh's responsible of exposing you fucking wicked ass prophets, man. Right? Dumbass, and you're bringing out Tobit chapter 4, verse 12, you dumb clown. Psalm 64, verse 9 now. And all men shall fear and shall declare the work of Yahweh, for they shall widely consider of his doing. Verse 10. Right? Verse 10. The righteous shall be glad in the Lord and shall trust in him. Right? The righteous shall be glad in the Lord. The righteous shall be glad in the Lord and shall trust in him. You gotta trust in the Lord Yahweh Shem Yahushua, man. Right? And all the upright in heart shall glory, man. You see that? So you gotta put your trust in the Lord. Don't put your trust in these wicked ass niggas and these strange children, right? That are preaching the Bible. Where did it say to follow man, right? Father sent his son, right? So you can follow him, not man. He told you to follow his son, Christ, to follow in his footsteps. He was the example, man. Not yous, right? That's how we know you don't have the spirit of Yahweh Shah Hamash Yad in you, man. Otherwise, we'd be able to connect, bro. You are not spiritually connecting to us, right? There's certain scriptures that you do speak of the truth, but you don't have it, bro. Right? Especially that name and who you're calling upon, man. Right? So, Lord willing, that was edifying. Right? I'm going to go out in the highways and hedges and rebuke this devil. Right? The saints have got to do what they got to do. Right? Lord willing, that was edifying. I want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh Shah, Bashim, Rakakadash. Right, Prakta Tham to all the brothers out there preaching in sincerity and truth. Shalom to the 12 tribes of Israel, scattered abroad. Shalom.